In this section, I'll be covering contract data reports and standard reports. Standard reports are 36 business rule defined reports. They can be located under the data bank and the report type standard. And they will be grouped in several pages, as you may see under our navigation. Let's go with one of these reports. I'll be scrolling down and showing you how to run and generate a report from Buy American Ag Place of Manufacture report. As you may see, next to this report, there is a darkened star. This is because this is one of my favorite reports. You can add these reports to your favorites by clicking on these stars, disabling and enabling to be a favorite. Once you have done that selection, you can limit your look of contract data reports, standard reports, by selecting favorites, and it will only show your favorites in this section. I'm going to undo that, and I'm going to just go and click on Buy American Ag Place of Manufacture. Once clicked, you will be given a new page. In this new page, you will have the title of the report, an area that you can expand by clicking on this mouse, and it gives you a description of this report. I'm going to minimize that by clicking on that. Then we will have a report criteria. Report criteria walks you through to enter a date range that's relevant to date sign on procurement awards. For our sample sake, I'm going to be using one of the fiscal years that I am familiar with. Once enter a date range, this can be any date range up to 12 years, I believe. You will be given an opportunity to enter organization code. My default organization is 4700-General Services Administration. If you know your code, you can type it in the code number, or you can click here and start the keywords of your organization, such as state. And you will have all the agencies that contain, departments or agencies that contain the name state. For example, Department of State 1900. You can select that, and you can add them in here by selecting them. 9700, which is DOD. I click on that and it adds to this list. I can eliminate these items from my list by clicking this X and taking them out. For the example's sake, I'm going to be using just 4700. And then, if you like, you can add a contracting office region. You can do a drop down and you can add this your contract interest of area of interest for the contracting office region. So at this menu, you have an option to execute the report, save the report, or clear, or click on PDF export, and it will directly export to PDF. And at the bottom section, you will see a disclaimer as an information window. And at the bottom section, you have an appendix. When you click on the appendix, you will see the disclosures that come with this reporting module. I'm going to go ahead and execute the report. And it will take my report criteria and combines it with my standard report and runs it against the database and quickly brings the result set. Once you establish a report criteria, you can repurpose this report criteria by saving it. You can click on Save button, and it will ask you what kind of a name you would like to give to it. I would say fiscal year 2018, or actually, that would be 2019, my bad, and hit Save. And report criteria was successfully saved. Now I have one more option that's added to these buttons. That would be save and save as. Save would be there because if I want to change the date, let's say, and hit save, it will overwrite my save report criteria. And I can correct that as save as. Save. I overwrite it again and I corrected it. Now, let me add 2 years in here. Even though it's a future date, I can do that. And I can do save as fiscal year 2019 and fiscal year 2020. And hit save. And I created another report criteria. Let's go ahead and execute this report and go back to standard reports. Once you come back to this Buy American Act Place of Manufacture report, you have a section here called Saved Criteria. If you click on the arrow, it will expand the section and you will have fiscal year 2019 and you have fiscal year 2019 and fiscal year 2020, which I created today, both of them. But as you see, I ran one of them, date last run. Even though I created this report criteria, it never ran. These are the old ones that I created in my previous presentations, which I can get rid of them by clicking on the X. And since I run this guy, I can run only 2019. By clicking on 2019, it will populate the report criteria for me. And I can either execute and get my report, or let's go back. Sorry, go back to standard reports. And go back to save criteria, 2019. In this window, I can do either execute, or if I like a PDF, I can hit PDF export, and I will get the PDF of it. I'm going to go ahead and execute the report, and it will take the report criteria and combines it with my standard report and runs it against the database and quickly brings the result set. A report that's embedded in a window, and the navigation can be achieved by sliding sideways at the bottom. This is in grid format, and you will be able to print this report by clicking this button. Once clicked, you will be prompted a print options window. I'm going to leave everything default, except I'm going to change to landscape and click on show printable version. And I will be given a 10-page report, as you see here, the cover page. It will show me my report filter, the dates that I selected, and my department, and what kind of a report I'm using, and what kind of an ID it has, which is Buy American Place of Manufacture report flag. Once you start scrolling down, you will see the result set. And in each page, your department will repeat, and you will see different type of metrics. Since it cannot fit 36 columns next to each other, it fits so many of them in one page and generates the report that way. By clicking on the X, you can close the tab and go back to where you left off. One other function that we brought is emailing from this interface. It's called Send Now. Once clicked, you will be prompted to enter, select from your address list, or enter a new email address by clicking on 2. Once clicked on 2, you can enter the physical email address here and put a nickname for that address by address name. In here, I will be using a sample email. I'll be using my name and number three, since I have a bunch of them. And I'll be using a dummy email address. And I can click on Add to Recipients. And it will add it to my address book, and also it will put in my recipients list. I can add or remove recipients or CC or BCC recipients from this list. I can do so by removing, selecting the name and using the arrow, and selecting the name and adding to CC, or selecting the name, adding to BCC, and click OK. It will be updating the dialog box for me. Then it will give me a send up option. Data in email is a good way to go. Delivery format will be HTML or PDF or Excel or plain text or CSV. I'm going to be choosing CSV, comma separated values. And I have given an option to compress the contents, make it into a zip file, which I highly recommend. By selecting that, you will compress the contents. And file name, you can add any file name you like. You're not going to be changing the file name here. It's just the attachment file name. When it generates the file to be attached to the email, it will add your flavor to it. I can say parentheses Ardar, and maybe a date or a time that will be ideal, such as 08/28/2020, and close the parentheses. And I can add a subject area, then I can add a message. Then I have an area called advanced options, and I expand that by clicking on show. In this area, when I choose this compress contents, I'm given a choice of password protect zip file. Since this became a zip file, I can add a password to it. By selecting that, you can provide a password in here. And you can provide that password to your recipient on a different communication medium. So you can establish another secure way to deliver your data. I'm going to leave it empty, and I'm just going to click OK. And you will see a sign up here. It will give you a disclaimer that it may take a few more minutes than you expected, depending on the server time and the traffic. And your message has been sent. Now, the next one would be export. If you click here, you will export whatever you see to Excel, CSV, Excel bit formatting, HTML, or plain text. I will choose Excel bit plain text. If you like, you can export the report title, even export the filter details. I'm going to remove that and click on export. And it will generate a file. It will either put it in the download folder, or if it's defaulted on your computer, it will open it in Excel. And this is a your copy, so you can enable editing. And by selecting the top corner and double clicking on column length, it will automatically fit all the data in the cells for you. And once you are ready, you can close the window from this link, or you can X out from here. In this case, I'm going to be closing the window from here. The next final option will be the PDF. Once clicked, you will be given the option to create this report into a PDF file. And you will have all the choices as you were given when you were printing to Excel, or saving it as exporting to Excel or other formats. And under here, you will have advanced options. You can choose your letter type. You may be putting on legal paper, And you may choose your margins as you wish. You can have maximum header size. And let's see how it brings the data back for us. Click on export. And it will generate a PDF file, which is 6 pages long. You can download this or print this by clicking on this button, or X out to go back. Now, let's go back to standard reports by clicking this link. As you see, I never use back and forth button of my browser. I always use the navigation that's within our betasam.com. Once click the standard report hyperlink, back at standard report. Now, again, I'm going to be using the same report, so I'm going to go to, let's do this. Under standard, I'm going to select favorites, my favorite one and only report, and I can expand that area, and I can use one of the saved criteria. Now, I want to alter this saved criteria by adding another organizational code. Let's say 4720 sub-tier, or I can have FAS, or you can say Federal Acquisition Service 3732, even though it belongs to General Service Administration, I added that. And I can overwrite that by saving it, or I can leave it as is and I can hit execute. It will run this report again according to the new selection criteria. So there will be another processing taking place, as you may see. Now, it didn't show anything because it belongs to this department. Our reporting module carries a functionality called drill down. Drilling down gives us the opportunity to drill from an attribute that we define a data by, which is like department, to a different level. In order to do so, you right click on the department and you select drill, and you will be given certain destinations. That may be contracting agency, contracting office region, the fiscal year, and a bunch of other details. And at the end of this selection, you have award detail, which is basically PIID level of data at award level breakdown of this information. For our example's sake, I'm going to be using fiscal year and drilling down to a fiscal year from the department. Again, it will take the report, change the report definition and run it against the database and bring the data back. As you may see, since my selection expanded into 2 fiscal years, it will break down the data into 2 fiscal years. But the totals shall be the same as the first row that I showed you. If you may remember this number, you can go back, and the number shall be same in here. So it gives us an opportunity to analyze our data at a lower level. In this area, we always dig your mind, because it's important for us to perfect our business flows, and you can provide a feedback. I thank you for your time.